Welcome. We are happy to have you today to talk about our cooperative. Here, we will tell you what our cooperative stands for, what it has to offer to its members, and what members are expected to do for the cooperative. Let us start by answering what is first and foremost in your minds. What is CFI? CFI is the short name for Cebu CFI Community Cooperative, established since 1970, a registered cooperative of good standing with the Cooperative Development Authority, a government regulatory agency tasked with supervising cooperatives in the country. The next question that will come into your mind is, why use CFI as its name? These three letters carry no special significance unless we go back in time when it all began 50 long years ago. Back then, the employees of the Court of First Instance of Cebu were victims of the abusive lending practices of money lenders, or loan sharks as we call them today. By the way, Courts of First Instance of Cebu, as they were then called, were the primary courts in the country which first heard and decided civil and criminal cases. Today, they are now called Regional Trial Courts, or RTC. Typical of any employee at that time, most of the CFI court personnel did not see their salaries on paydays as they were already mortgaged to the so-called loan sharks at usurious interest rates of 10 to 20% per month. In the end, these employees eventually fell into a debt trap, a vicious cycle of indebtedness that chained them to these loan sharks for the rest of their lives. So, CFI was born. It was founded by the late Judge Esperanza Garcia with the intention of liberating these court personnel from the bondage of loan sharks. The idea was very simple. Why not form a cooperative where members with some funds to invest will collectively contribute to a pooled fund for other members to borrow? It was a win-win proposition for both the member investor and the member borrower. The member investor will earn more than what he earns from banks, while the member borrower will be obtaining a loan at interest rates much lower than those charged by the loan sharks. So, in April 1970, the cooperative was formed with 29 members and a capital of 200 pesos. Today, it is a multi-billion cooperative with more than 140,000 members. The three letters of CFI were carried as part of the name of the cooperative, for it was originally intended as a cooperative for CFI personnel. However, as the cooperative expanded to other offices and establishments in the government and private sectors, the word community was added to its name. Yet, for want of a shorter name, members simply called the cooperative CFI, and this name stuck until now. Today, CFI no longer stands for Court of First Instance, as the cooperative where members always ran to at the first instance of financial need, the letters now stand for Co-op of First Instance. From its historical backdrop, CFI is grounded on two pillars of support that form the foundation for its very existence. First, investment of members into a pooled fund for other members to borrow at reasonable rates of interest. Second, loans for members out of the pooled fund to generate decent returns for the member investors. These two pillars define what CFI is, its purpose, and its mission. Let us discuss in detail these two pillars of support, for they are also the principal basis for the major services and facilities of the cooperative. At CFI, investment can take the form of share capital, savings, and time deposits. What is share capital? Share capital are equity contributions of a member in the capital structure of the cooperative. It is not a deposit which a member can withdraw anytime. It is, in one sense, like shares of stocks in a corporation, but different in a sense that it will not be the basis for voting in cooperative affairs by a member. In a cooperative, a member has only one vote regardless of the amount of contribution. So, unlike a deposit, a share capital cannot be withdrawn by a member without the approval of the board of the CFI and only after 3 years from its contribution. However, the share capital of a member is entitled to earn dividends from the surplus profits of the cooperative at year-end in proportion to the amount of contribution. Pursuant to the Cooperative Code of the Philippines, these dividends are tax-exempt income. Under present policy, a member must maintain at least 2,000 pesos in share capital but can invest up to 200,000 pesos in share capital contribution for every year of membership. For the past several years, CFI has been consistently distributing dividends to its members at the rate equivalent to 8% of the amount of their contribution. Although this is not a guarantee, management at CFI strives to generate such rate of return every year. Then, we have savings and time deposits. Savings and time deposits are money placements of members with the CFI which generate interest income if not withdrawn for a specified period of time. Again, pursuant to the Cooperative Code, these interest income are tax-exempt. Savings deposit generate interest income at 3% per annum provided it is not withdrawn for 90 days. Time deposits generate interest income at the rate of 5% per annum provided they are not withdrawn for a period of 12 months. The second pillar of support of CFI is loans for members. Loans for members are generally classified into employees' loans, special individual loans, commercial loans, microfinance loans, personal advantage loan, and credit cash line. Employees' loans are loans extended to members where the basis for computation of the loan amount is either their basic salary, net take-home pay, or amount of benefits received from employment. Under this category are the following types of loans: salary loan, bonus loan, which could either be mid-year or 13th month, benefit loans, special judicial loans such as grocery, rice allowance, economic allowance, and judicial development fund. Special individual loans are loans extended to individual members where the basis for computing loan amount are certain sources of income or collateral securities other than the compensation from employment. These are pension loans, allotment loans, deposit loans, personal advantage loans. The personal advantage loans is available for members to answer for their personal financial needs such as medical expenses, school tuition fees, house repairs or renovations, family travel, and such other types of personal expenses where a member can only afford to spend for them or paid through installments over a certain period of time. The borrowing member can borrow up to a minimum of 100,000 pesos and a maximum of 1 million pesos. The loan is based on your computed monthly installment capacity and provided that you are a member in good standing. You only need to provide a copy of your latest income tax return and bank statement for the current year. Apply for PAL online through your e-services account. For more details, visit www.cficoop.com. And credit cash line. Members can avail for the credit cash line, your virtual credit card. You are given an automatic credit line of 10,000 to 50,000 if you have an existing savings or time deposits or share capital with CFI in amounts of 50,000 pesos or more. If you are not qualified for the automatic grant, You may apply for your credit cash line through the loan application menu at your e-services account. You are asked to provide a copy of your latest income tax return and certified net take-home pay. Once credit line is approved, you can withdraw the amount using your CFI wallet. Just like a credit card, any principal repayment done on the amount drawn will restore the credit line of the members up to the equivalent amount of repaid principal. For more details, visit our official website at www.cficoop.com. CFI also offers business loans to members in the form of commercial loans, commercial credit line. The commercial credit line is a revolving credit line granted to members used exclusively for the purpose of funding a business, whether new or existing. After appraisal of the collateral securities offered to secure the line, a maximum allowable loan amount will be made available, which you can withdraw one time or an installment at several stages, provided they are done within 12 months from the date of approval of the line. Interested members should accomplish the prescribed form in applying for a commercial credit line by downloading the application form at our website and provide all information or data required and attaching all relevant documents. Submit to any CFI office in the country and you should be ready to appear for a personal interview with the credit committee of CFI for purposes of evaluation. Once credit line is approved, you can withdraw the amount online using your CFI wallet. Lastly, the microfinance loans. One of the distinct privileges of a member who borrows from the cooperative fund is a privilege of receiving a patronage refund. Patronage refund entitles a borrowing member a refundable rebate equivalent to percentage of the total interest paid for his loan in a calendar year. For a more detailed discussion of these loans, please go to our website at www.cficoop.com. In addition to these services, CFI has a health plan under the so-called Mutual Medical Assistance Fund, or MMAF. For an annual contribution of 6,240 pesos, a member can claim up to a maximum of 100,000 pesos in medical and hospital expenses in a covered year. To ensure the sustainability of this fund, members below 60 years of age are required to participate. For more details about this fund, please go to our website at www.cficoop.com. While membership at the CFI entitles the members with certain privileges, such as the right to avail of the services mentioned, it all carries certain responsibilities to ensure its continued operation. First, every member must pay an annual membership dues of 1,000 pesos. Second, a member must always maintain an updated record of his personal data in the CFI database. This is particularly very important in cases his mobile phone number, postal address, bank records, and sources of income such as salary, pension amount, allotment amount, and such other required sources of income. This data will be used by CFI not only in sending notices to the member, but also in the delivery of CFI services. Every member must pay all his outstanding obligations to the co-op when they are due for payment. As a rule, any outstanding obligation which is not paid after 90 days from its due date will be considered in default. A member must at all times avoid having any of his loan obligations to go in default. Otherwise, a member in default will suffer these consequences. Firstly, membership with the cooperative will be suspended, resulting in suspension of enjoyment in any CFI services. Secondly, membership will be reported to the Credit Information Corporation for blacklisting. CIC is a government corporation which keeps all records of loan status from individual borrowers in order for financial institutions to view and conduct credit background checks. Thirdly, Pursuant to Article 59 of the Cooperative Code of the Philippines, CFI has a lien over deposits of the defaulting member with any bank in the Philippines, which can be attached to answer for the loan in default. Finally, a civil action for collection will be filed in court. Understandably, these drastic actions will be resorted to as funds used for loans are funds of the members. CFI has various types of support facilities to enable its members to transact for any of the services and facilities available to them. CFI has its central office at the Esperanza Garcia Building, Capitol Compound, Cebu City, while its regional offices is located at Unit 801 to 802, Ayala Tower, Ayala Avenue, Ayala Triangle, Barangay Bel Air, Makati City, and Abriza Mall, Davao Space Number 3069, 3rd Level Floor, JP Laurel Avenue, Poblacion District, Davao City. It has also 30 satellite and branch offices nationwide. A member can go to any of these offices and a CFI personnel will be there to address any of their concerns. However, one does not even have to go personally to these offices in order to transact with CFI. Through the online e-services of Cebu CFI Co-op, you can now update your profile, may it be your basic information, employment status, change profile picture, change password, and monitor the status of your transactions. The CFI wallet, where you can now cash in and cash out funds. View your statement of accounts, either deposits, loans, and withdrawals. Apply for a loan or renew the same. Withdraw your deposits or use it to pay your existing loans. Know your outstanding accounts and pay them online using the online payment gateway. With CFI Wallet, adding funds is now easy through cash-in, where you can now deposit money for your CFI Wallet through your credit cash line, debit card, CFI savings deposit, online bank transfer, bank over-the-counter, e-wallet, or remittance centers. You can transfer money to anyone through the cash out button that allows you to withdraw from your CFI wallet and choose a variety of methods. You can transfer through CFI check or bank transfer, where CFI will do the transfer to your preferred bank accounts, through InstaPay or PesoNet, remittance centers, transfer to your Union Bank account, and to your CFI deposits or shared capital. Second, you can go to any of the 2,500 M. Luillier branches nationwide in order to apply for a loan or renew a loan, withdraw a deposit, update any data of your membership profile, pay a loan or health fund contribution. A member can just download the forms needed for those transactions at www.cficoop.com or download the CFI Co-op application on the smartphone, and all these services will be available to the member at his fingertips anytime and anywhere. And contacting CFI for any question or concern can be done effectively through modern channels of communication. Now, a member does not have to leave the confines of his home in order to send a query or concern to CFI. CFI has the most modern help desk in the country at your e-services account at www.cficoop.com. Here, a member receives email and text messages for every action done on his case. He can also track the status of his case by logging in the assigned ticket number in the CFI help desk. Better still, use the CFI call center by dialing 032-255-2525, and a call center agent will be there to listen to a member's concern. There you are. That is CFI, a cooperative which has been with us for more than 50 years. And for the multitude of its members, it is and will always be our co-op of first instance.
tai.